7 inches or 18 centimetres, this Batman DC McFarlane. McFarlane Toys DC Multiverse Batman Flashpoint action figure is pretty special. I always thought it was going to be cool, but just getting it in hand, it is one of those rare toys which is really something special. I'll zoom in and give you just a little bit of a closer look, but straight away, the sculpt of this is just awesome. The weapons are phenomenal. Just go and buy it. That's all the review you need to know. I'll show you in more detail in just a minute. There's a link in the description below where you can go buy it. This was a US Target exclusive. Outside of the US, it is available in some select online stores. It just depends. And there's a few on eBay as well, but you got to pick this one up. It's really definitely worth it. The packaging is pretty standard stuff for McFarlane. We get some very nice Flashpoint art on the back. Lots of other figures there, all of which are reviewed on the channel. Apart from that Green Lantern, still haven't got that one yet. Every other one is reviewed and on there. You can have a look at that in our DC McFarlane channel. And we get this gorgeous artwork there, as it says on the side of the box, from Batman 22 in 2017. Not much else on the box, got the usual artwork inside. I've kind of ripped it open to get the stand and the trading card out. And the usual kind of classic comic part in there. As it says up at the top, 22 points of articulate, or 22 moving points, it says. Point articulé in the McFarlane Toys logo. Nothing else to really report. I love these boxes, I love the back of them, but I do feel they could do with a bit of redesign to kind of, I don't know, just encapsulate more about them, because the art looks great and they really need to accommodate more. I think there's the UPC, but again, link in the description to buy it. So the trading card is again same as per the art, beautifully done. For once we're really getting a figure that looks exactly like the comic art, really truly does. There's some text on the back. And if no, you're not misreading this, if you're not aware, this is a kind of what if story. What happened if it was actually Bruce Wayne that died in the alleyway, in Crime Alley, or whatever it was, rather than his dad? And his dad becomes the Batman in this Flashpoint story. It's kind of bonkers, I have to say. Crime Alley, my apologies. So, yeah, it's a kind of bonkers story, but very well drawn, and it looks beautiful, so it's well worth picking up the trade paperback or having a read online, etc. It's, yeah, kind of interesting. But it comes with a stand, I should say, as well. Doesn't truly need it too badly, but it's still welcome nonetheless. But the Batman is fantastic. And again, it's not Bruce, it's Thomas. The eyes are beautifully done. Really strong red in them. They really just jump out. It's not really showing it too much here under the light, I don't think. But God, they're really kind of piercing. Really, really strong. We got a nice shiny red on the chest plate there with the Batman logo, raised and embossed up, and these red belts around the figure which hold the weapons, and then some nicely detailed boots with kind of scoring and sculpt all throughout them. And quite honestly, it is just a great looking figure. One of the other reasons it looks fantastic is these weapons are outstandingly good. Thick and chunky, really looking incredibly weathered and looking realistic gunmetal. They've just done a bloody fabulous job on this. Now, if we witness a little bit what Hasbro did recently with the Deadpool movie figure, of which I bitched endlessly because it deserves a kick in the bum, this was the weapons they had, which they glued into the holster. Now, that is obviously broken because I had to get it out, but these were thick and chunky monkeys with weathering and silver and detail on it. Hasbro glued theirs in, but there was nothing on it, it was just black plastic. So I understand cost sometimes, and you know, there's a difference between a movie licensed figure such as Deadpool and a likeness and so forth, and a license they have to pay, which they still have to pay for DC, but will be less because it's comics. So there is a cost differential. But what is happening for Hasbro is McFarlane are kicking your arse in terms of paint. Certainly in sculpt, I think there's competitiveness without a doubt. Yes, Hasbro have the facial scan tech, which is really pretty good. This is from a comic. But I think in terms of capturing the figure, they nailed it. They absolutely bloody nailed it. The facial sculpt is there. The figure is exactly out of the comic. The red belt is there. It does have a little bit more weathering and definition, so a little bit more paint on that, a little wash of paint across that. Frankly, would have just finished this figure and would have just, in my mind, nailed it. The paint, tone, coloring, capturing that weird cape with the kind of weird pieces there, again, beautifully done. The cape at the back is kind of nicely sculpted and well done again, and kind of just looks fantastic. Works really well on the figure. It is glued in the back, but it does hold it together pretty well. And there's enough weight and solidity in the figure to just hold it together, and it's just fab. The articulation on McFarlane is a little strange for some of us, I think, that are relatively new to the line, but it's kind of warming on me. And some of the extras, even though I don't use them, like toe articulation, and frankly, I would get rid of them, it's nice to have, and it certainly can aid in some toy photography. So it's definitely an option. I would get rid of it and focus more on these ankles. Not a fan of the ankles, but again, the more you see it, you barely see it, you barely notice it. So, it's not that bad. Pins and joints could be something that could be improved, I think, but ultimately, I just love this figure. There's something about the figure just looking really good. It captures it, the facial tone, the little bit of stubble on the chin, the red in the eyes, the tiny details in the sculpt around the eyes, the side profile of it, the weapons look phenomenal. It is just a really good figure. It's always the same with some toys. There's just something about it. And you may not like it, you may not see it, but I think most people will. It is a pretty damn cool Batman, and I absolutely urge you to go and buy it. So there you go. McFarlane Toys are definitely kicking ass recently. They've really just been knocking it out of the park. Yes, there's a lot of Batman. That is a critique. Yes, they're not perfect in articulation, but this one is definitely. Start here. If you've never started in the line yet, you won't regret it. In terms of articulation on him, his head is pretty movable considering he has the cape and the cowl and everything else. But it's not too shabby that far down and relatively far back, but not super articulated. But still, again, for Batman, that's not too bad with all the gear that's going on. We've got a kind of semi butterfly joint piece that works with McFarlane Toys, but it does a good job. It gives you that extra, excuse me, kind of piece to just move and articulate your figures. The ball joint up at the top of the shoulders. You've got a bicep swivel, double joint at the elbows. Slightly weird wrists, I have to say. I'm not a big fan of these weird kind of circles. I've kind of had a often where they've just popped apart, but see what I mean? See if you just bend it the wrong way. But it does the job. So you get a full swivel going on there, which is not too bad. Upper ab crunch is really pretty damn awesome all the way around. Plenty of movement overall. Legs have that. Do we have a waist articulation? No, we don't. We have that weird chunky part are buried way within there, which gives you a kind of thigh swivel, or barely a thigh swivel. Down to double joints at the knees and rocking ankles and toes and stands for these peckles. So definitely one I would recommend you pick up, and let us know what you think. I'd love to hear your thoughts. If you did, do you like it? Let us know. We will see for more McFarlane Toys reviews coming up, as well as all the other usual Hasbro stuff. That's it. See you soon.